Cody Rhodes, a few of those limited edition t-shirts for tonight's match. Looking for a giveaway, Cody Rhodes. T-shirts myself.
We thought this might have been a match of respect. This might have been one of them matches with two great competitors, but no, Pete Dunne has just
Pete
made
Dunne's
this.
In this match.
Yeah, Pete Dunne has made this very, very personal.
Oh, under the legs there goes Cody. Basement uppercut, shades of gold dust there from Cody Rhodes. And a kick to the stomach. Learned that from Southside alumni Bob Holly.
Yeah, of course. Cody Rhodes' former tag team partner.
Oh, Cody sent over the top to the floor. But Pete Dunne looks to come over. Goes for a chop and misses. Cody Rhodes moves out of the way.
Cody Rhodes, as you saw on that entrance video there, part of one of wrestling's royal families, the Rhodes family. And Cody Rhodes currently enjoying a career renaissance here. All over the world. He's in England at the moment on the independent scene.
Cody Rhodes is making a hell of a name. He's doing what no one else has ever done before. And that is wrestle the same time for people like Evolve, Ring of Honor, TNA. Cody Rhodes is the only person to wrestle at WrestleMania this year. Go to TNA Bound for Glory and also wrestle the Ring of Honor's biggest show of the year as well.
And the Southside 6-year anniversary thing.
Exactly. All the biggest shows in wrestling and Cody Rhodes is involved in them. Cody and Pete just fighting up in the stands. Of Pete looking to pick him up, and he does. The slams Cody Rhodes down up on the steps there.
Pete Dunne is having a phenomenal year. We're talking about the year Cody Rhodes is having. Pete Dunne, he's got wins over names like Haskins, Sammy Callahan, Eddie Kingston, Tigre Uno, Shane Strickland, Ray Phoenix, Tommy End. The list goes on. All these great names. Blake, for
a lot
example.
Of great names. Pete Dunne is just dominating for everyone. And why? Because of his attitude. Pete Dunne has changed things up. Pete Dunne knew the way he was heading, nothing was going to happen for him. Pete Dunne had to, I talked earlier about finding that switch. Pete Dunne has done that. The young and bitter, the bruiserweight man. Pete Dunne was part of the inaugural first round of the Cruiserweight Classic.
Pete Dunne has literally grabbed his career and potential by the balls and is just not letting go.
They say reach the brass ring, they say break that shattered glass, that ceiling. Pete Dunne is doing that this year. And Pete Dunne could do that again and make even more of a statement by beating a man like Cody Rhodes.
Man with a legacy of Rhodes.
Oh, a big stop from the elbow.
A second generation wrestler. See, he's got the word dream tattooed across his heart. I was very, very lucky enough to speak to Cody earlier on. The memory and the love that he has for his father is incredible. He's doing his father proud by travelling the world, plying the trade and keeping that Rhodes name alive.
And look at those right hands though from Cody. Across the forehead, that right hand taped up as well, Cody. His back driven into that turnbuckle. Oh, well, Pete just pulling at the face there of Cody. Trying to make Cody undashing. This time connects with a hard chop.
Well, there's one back.
Overhand.
Cody drives his shoulder with that solid steel turnbuckle. Give Dunn the opportunity to capitalise on this match.
On his head, Cody Rhodes' head bouncing off the post there.
Wonder if he's still got his face guard.
Cody, dazed, probably not know where he is, rolls into the ring. Maybe not the smart manoeuvre after his head getting driven into that post.
We need to be switched on if you're going to be in the ring with someone like Pete Dunne. That young and bitter drives the hand. Oh, in ways it's just not meant to bend.
Just bent the fingers, put the arm bent on the canvas and just stomps on the tricep and the elbow area of Cody Rhodes.
When you look at Cody Rhodes, I mean, what most people don't know about Cody Rhodes, he's a two-time Georgia State Amateur Wrestling Champion. He's very
you don't want to mat wrestle with Cody Rhodes.
But then Pete Dunne, he's going for it. Look at the submission manoeuvre on the legs as well as, well, oh my God, stamping onto the hamstrings and the knees.
Nothing much technical about biting a man's fingers and stomping on his
knees. Damage that it does, Flynn.
Oh, I'm not saying it doesn't work, it's not effective. I'm just saying it's not technical.
It's not technical, God, but no, it works.
Cody Rhodes has rocked, you can see there. Just dizzy. Bouncing off the ropes. Thrown off. Into a clothesline. Cody in the ring. Lackadaisical cover there, though. Kick out at one. The difference. Hook in the leg can change a match.
This picture right here, right now, when everyone's talking about Cody Rhodes and he's flavour of the month, he's talk of the town across the independent scene. Pete Dunne is dominating him.
He's pulling Cody up by his nose. Head first, though.
Cody's actually wrestling defensively right now, trying to stop the onslaught of Pete
Dunne. They just collided into each other. You heard the collision. Cody on his hands and knees trying to gather his thoughts. You can see he's still not 100% after his head into that turnbuckle post.
And now Cody's gone to that place. Cody's summoning up some energy, like almost the last bastion of motivation that he's got. And then blows to the head of Pete Dunne. Pete takes them.
Back and forth. Right hand, right forearm.
First man to fall down,
jab,
loses.
Jab. Rocking and rolling.
Oh, oh no. You see that bionic elbow, but Pete Dunne just stops it dead in his tracks.
Rocking and rolling, duking and diving, but it didn't happen. And Cody, though, colliding, driving Pete down. Catches the arm. I'll go for the crossroads. No, drops him back first.
Cody Rhodes, the uncommon man, the star that left them in the dust. Standing tall here at the Southside Wrestling 6-year anniversary show. Can he break the streak
runs
of Pete
off the
Dunne?
Road. Oh, Pete catches him. Snap, German. Suplex there from Pete. He's got Cody up. Looking for a back suplex, though. Cody lands on his feet, kicks him. Oh, Pete
dear.
Had it scouted this
He's
time.
Gifted him. He's gifted him the fingers, and there's that bite.
Basement uppercut, but Pete Dunne. Disaster kick.
Oh no!
Disaster elbow. That's not good there for Pete Dunne. Powerbomb. Cody's down.
Right in the center of the ring, Flinny, too.
Pete Dunne.
Cody Rhodes kicks out.
Pete Dunne nearly with the biggest win in his career there against Cody Rhodes. Hops over.
Dunne's going to go high. How many times do you see Pete Dunne go to the top rope?
I can't say I have. Jumps off, stomps.
Right to the ribs, right to the midsection.
Oh, Cody kicks. Cody kicks out.
That is a superhuman ability to have kicked out after a double foot stomp from Pete Dunne.
Absolutely unreal.
I don't think Dunne can believe it. What has Pete Dunne got to do to put away the grandson of a plumber?
Well, you just said, have I ever seen Pete Dunne go up the top rope? No, that shows you what he's trying to do. He's trying to do something out of the ordinary to beat Cody Rhodes.
I think he's got to do something out of the
ordinary.
But
he feels like that was good enough. If he can connect one more time, that could be it.
Rhodes is still down.
Can Pete Dunne strike gold?
No, not this
time. No, the uppercut connects.
Knocking Pete Dunne. Gives Cody just enough time to regroup.
Yes, disaster kick connects on the apron.
Is the Pete Dunne winning streak over? Finally.
And Cody Rhodes stands in the middle of the ring tall. You can see he's feeding off the crowd. He beats the chest.
The Southside fans absolutely loving Cody Rhodes right now.
Pete's head driven across the metal turnbuckle. Cody has him hooked. Pete on the outside, Cody up top. And a superplex!
The whole ring shook!
And Pete hooks the leg! Pete's got him hooked, that could be it!
Both men back to their feet straight
catches
away!
Catches the arm,
Cody
crossroads, crossroads, down he goes!
Hooks the leg, the straight,
game over, Pete's done! Wow! Wow!
Pete Dunne kicks out against all odds, Flinny. Rhodes can't believe it.
Cody has won championship after championship with that crossroads.
Pete kicked out.
How? How enough is Pete Dunne still standing after that?
God knows. And now we're going to see Cody go for the high-risk manoeuvre. Pete Dunne is getting back to his
up
feet.
Top
Cody
again.
Doesn't know.
He's looking for that move, so he does. Oh, he pulled the referee in the way.
The referee?
Pete protected himself by pulling the referee.
The referee took the full force of that. Cody didn't know what's going on. Pete Dunne's plan. And Cody doing the right thing by looking to check on the ref.
Oh, but Pete picks him up. Drop dead. No.
But no, Cody knows what was coming. Off the
disaster
ref.
Kick again. Connects.
And
goes
now
for the cover.
Cody with a pin. One, but there's no referee.
The referee's been knocked out with a moonsault.
There's Cody. No referee. The pin doesn't matter. We know Rhodes can beat Dunne. We know he's got him down. But it doesn't matter. There is no law in that ring right now.
The referee's just...
Referee's kind of broke his glasses. I don't know if he's getting back to his feet or if he's being rolled out of the way.
Oh, Pete Dunne!
With a knee to the Rhodes family jewels.
Picks him up. Drop dead, connects, face first.
And now, with the referee just regaining a little bit of consciousness.
But after a low blow.
Dunne goes for the pin. One.
Cody kicks out. The low blow, the drop dead.
The referee was slow in his count after being just knocked out. Otherwise, this would have
all been fault. If Pete Dunne hadn't pulled the referee in the way of the moonsault, he would have been there and been able to count
the
three.
But the fact of the matter is, gave Cody the time to kick
Pete
out.
Pete just pushes him. Oh, the low blow. Retribution.
There's your receipt, Pete.
Retribution for Cody. Crossroads connects again.
This
middle
time,
of the ring. Hooks the leg. Game over.
The winner of this match, the grandson of a plumber,